takes one up of the beast. Issa has to run the ball out wide. And they're coming in from depth. Their formation from depth is quite, quite exquisite. Simple try running. David Omron, is it? Yes, David Omron.
And another display of why coming in from depth always works.
Oh, yes, indeed. Rugby one-on-one. Tackle low, coming from depth. The ball will always find its way faster if you actually pass as opposed to running the ball in there. That's exactly what Samurai did in there.
Yeah, and even the slow-mo replay evidences that for that. But he seemed to smash it to Collins Kimani along the way.
Well, you know, it's the mentality of a rugby player. When you get a chance to go on through and just make someone look bad, you take all your chances.
I hope you don't make me look bad.
Definitely indeed. With that try, Omron looks to be taking a breather. No, he's just walking out for the kickoff. I thought he was walking out for a breather. CBS Samurai extend the lead by 5 points. The lead currently stands at 22 points to 7, and Western Bulls really, really, really need to dig deep within themselves, because it looks like a tall order, especially in light of the fact that Samurai look like the tails up in the air and they're not leaving anything to chance. They're smelling blood and they want to take the kill. Hard tackle. Ball still stays in the field of play. Still retained by Western Bulls. You shouldn't really be taking the ball up into contact.
No, that's not the best thing to do, particularly when you're trailing this game by 15 points. You want to have that ball, you want to utilize it at every opportunity that you get.
And pound for pound, the Samurai players are much bigger, much stronger, and it's an exercise in futility when you're running the ball into twin towers such as Osun's. Crowd really getting animated, the stadium. Samurai with a put in quick scrum. Swanepoel spreads it out. Omron, the danger man out in there. They decide to bring the ball back in. Gerhard Scholes still with the ball. Gerhard Scholes takes two men to bring him down. Quite a mountain of a man. Samurai building up. Hard tackle in there, but Samurai still managed to place the ball. Omron has a very, very devastating step. We've seen that in the 2 days. I mean, defense splitting side steps that that was a show of good hands by the big man Swanepoel. Absolutely exquisite. Makes it look very easy. Brilliant try there by Yuan Swanepoel, who's been one of the standout players for this Samurai team from yesterday. Exquisite ball handling by Swanepoel there. One hand pick right up in there. Looked like he actually had glue in his hands. Thing of beauty there. Who tried? Conversion still set to come by Logan Basson. And he kicks it wayward. Alright, I don't really know what that was all about. Scores remain 27 for Samurai, 7 for Western Bulls. Samurai quickly running away with this. 3.5 minutes set to play, and it will be a tall order for Western Bulls, who perhaps need to actually just get into the game and play for a bit of pride. It looks like CBS Samurai pulling away this one. Western Bulls score about 5 or 6 times in 3.5 minutes. You don't really foresee that happening. Right from the kickoff again, Samurai on the onslaught. Western Bulls do the same thing. The referee is giving them a get out of jail card right there. There was a knock on from the kickoff, but it looked like it was going to be another turnover ball because they were held up by the very physically dominating Samurai players. Collins Odegwule takes a breather and has his final contribution in this year's tournament. In for him is Bran Watsoin. Samurai again on the onslaught. Turned over the scrum, and I mean, there's nothing going on the way for the Western Bulls. They can't retain their kickoffs, they can't retain their scrums, their liners are golden. Coach there called Newton Ongalo, looking quite concerned. Seemed to have actually hit the self-destruct button right there. Scrum being reset there by Samurai. Ball didn't look quite straight, but it doesn't matter. The referee lets it play. They seem to have numbers out in there, and Western Province are just trying to move on through. Another devastating step by Omron there, and second step was not as devastating. Almost looked like he had his ankle there because he fell quite heavily on it. still samurai, all samurai all over the place, still maintaining the ball and applying more and more pressure. Omrod seemed to have picked himself up. Didn't look as bad as it was initially. And samurai spotted Richard Priestley with the try.
They are going to definitely defend the play title for another year.
There was no one absolutely interested in making that tackle. Fended off the first person and the rest looked like they were pedestrians. Simple try. Bounced off the first person. Looked intimidatingly at the others. Looked a bit like he used one of his players to shield himself from the tackler. Anyway, story for another day. Samurai seem to have actually put this one into the bag, leading 34 points to 7 with a minute left on the clock. I think we already know who our 2013 play champions on the Safaricom Sevens event are. Definitely will be Samurai's name being inscribed on the trophy for the second year in a row. Western Province just picking up from the energy being generated by the partisan crowd who are really rallying behind them. They need to give something back to the ground. Line break in there, good hands, and they're off. Does he have the speed? Does he have the gas to get there? Lord is actually coming up behind him. And try, Alvin Otieno scores a try.
And that is Alvin Otieno's second try of the game.
It's always good to finish against the flash. Alvin Otieno signs off his 2013 campaign with a try right at the center. The conversion also good, and the final whistle coming up. Final score, Samurai emphatic 34-14 victors against a very resilient Western Bulls outfit who just couldn't seem to get their act together in the played final.
And while we give congratulations to CBA Samurai, let us also note the performance that Western Bulls have given. The club from Kakamega finished 8th in the National 7 Series, the Safaricom 7 Series, and they've even performed better than series champions KCB. They've gone all the way to the plate final.